Hello everyone, welcome to HTML Zero to Hero YouTube series, and today we will be learning about HTML iframe element, video and audio element. In last video we learned about CSS classes and ID, and we did some changes in our table which we created in our older videos. And today video is about the video element, audio element and iframes. Before we proceed with the tutorial, please like the video. Comment on the video to let me know what you like about the video and what you didn't like about the video. Also subscribe the channel. Okay, let's proceed with the tutorial now. So first I'm gonna remove the old code which we did to practice. So let's remove that. I'm gonna remove everything in our head styling which we did. Removing all the code from body. And now we will add an iframe. Iframe is used to display a web page within a web page. So for example, in my HTML page here, I can display another website within this web page. So let's suppose this website. So what I'm gonna do, I'll just embed this whole website within our website here by using an iframe. And to do that, we just added an element iframe, and now I'm gonna add the URL of the website which we want to embed within our page. So let's add the URL, copy the URL from here, add it here. Save the document, go back to the preview and hit refresh. And here we go. As you can see, we embed this website in our document. We can adjust width and height of the iframe by adding width and height attribute. So let's define a width and height for our iframe. Added 400 pixels for width and height. Now let's save the document. Go back to the preview. Hit save. And as you can see, it's a bit larger now as we adjusted the width and height. We can also add some styling to our iframe by using the style attribute, just like I'm doing it right now. So let's add a border. Save the document. And here's a preview. We have our iframe and border around it. And that's pretty much it for the iframe. Now we will move to our video element. So I'm gonna add video to our document. Just let's remove this for now. So that is our code for the video element. Within the inverted commas of SRC, we will be defining the path of our video. In this case, I have a video save here already. So what I'm gonna do, I'll just copy the name and paste it here. .mp4 is the file format. We can add the complete URL of the video as well here. if it's uploaded in your hosting or wherever your video is present, maybe if it's in Dropbox or wherever it is. So I'm just gonna save it now and go back to the preview. Okay, our video is not showing up, probably because we did some mistake in our code, and which is we didn't close our iframe tag by adding slash iframe, just like we closed the video element, but we didn't do the same for the iframe. That's why the video wasn't showing up. So what we're gonna do now, we close the iframe and save the document. Go back to preview, and here we go. Our video is showing up now. It's not playing because we didn't add any controls. So video element has an attribute controls, which is used to display the controls of the video, like play button, pause button, and moving it forward. So let's save it now and here's our document again. Refresh the page and here we go. Our video is working now.
Welcome to HTML Zero to Hero YouTube series.
Here we go.
In last video we learned how to
people can adjust the volume, we can make it full screen. It's working fine.
There's another attribute in video element for auto playing the video, and for that we will just add autoplay here.
And what it will do, it will automatically play the video whenever the document is refreshed. So let's save the document and see if it's working. Hit refresh.
Okay, so as you can see, our autoplay isn't working. The reason behind this is that Chrome, in the latest version of Chrome, they do not allow us to autoplay the video when the video is not muted. So when we're gonna add another attribute to mute our video, and then we'll save the document, go back to the video, hit refresh. And here we go. As you can see, our video is in autoplay mode now, but it's muted. That's because Chrome is not allowing the functionality of autoplay when it's not muted. Okay, that's pretty much it for the video element. Now we will see how we can add audio. Adding an audio file is pretty much identical to the video file element which we did. So let me add an audio file to show you guys how it works. So that's our code for the audio file, and here's the attribute for the control, similar to how we did in the video file. Now what we're gonna do, we will add the URL in within the SRC inverted commas to point our audio file, and I have this file already saved for you guys in my desktop. I'm just gonna add the name of the file here, audio.mp3. I'm gonna save the document and go back to see how it looks now. And here we go. Here you can see our audio file has been placed. Working as per the expectation. Okay, we added an iframe to our document, then we added a video file, then we added an audio file, and now we will add a YouTube video to our document. So I'm gonna go to my channel here. Click on any of the video of mine. And then I'm gonna right click. And here you can see the embed code for the YouTube video. That applies to all of the video. You can choose any of the YouTube video and right click on your mouse and copy the embed code and add it to your HTML document, just like I'm doing it now. So I just copied the embed code and paste it on a document here, and I'm gonna save the document. Go back to preview, hit refresh, and here we go. Our YouTube video has been embedded on our document. We can adjust width and height by changing the attribute values here, like 825441. We can add any width or height to whatever our document requires or however you want to lay it out. All right, that was a little big video. As per the normal routine, we learned about four elements: iframe, video element, audio element, and added a YouTube video. So that's pretty much it for the tutorial now. Until next time, have a great day.